Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
Okay, in my previous video, I had asked you, it was about time management. I told you that I once spent 3 days with the CEO of a company, okay? Really big time company, very big, okay? He had appointed me as a brand consultant for an event. And, you know, good money, really good money. $5,000 a day. That was a rate, which he, this was, I forgot how many years ago. What say, 8, 10, something. Okay, whatever. It was a couple of years ago. So the guy, he was, you know, agreed for $5,000 a day, 3 days, because he saw me giving a talk at an event, appointed me. This is in Dubai. Huh? Okay, serious money, serious work. Everything. Okay, fine. Now the contract was that I would be with him and his team for the next 3 days. Okay? And everything, you know, post-work, everything. The contract actually would not, even though it was just 3 days with him, after that there was work to be done. So I said, fine. So I was supposed to spend time with these guys. Now, this guy, he told me, we will pick you up, means I'm supposed to stay with them for the next 3 days for this mega event. So he said, I'll pick you up, I'll get you picked up, not he'll pick me up. My driver will pick you up at around like 5 in the morning, 5 or what was it, 4:30 something, okay, 5. So I was like, okay, I obviously had to prepare for the whole day and sleep on time. I got up at 1 o'clock, kept everything ready. Ready means everything. Had my coffee, food, made sure I didn't have to go to the toilet. Because, you know, you're going to travel for quite some time. On road, not airplane and all that. So, I took, with the help of my girlfriend, I got dropped at a particular place because I didn't want to leave my car there. So she dropped me there and then she went back home. So I waited there. My girlfriend dropped me there and she waited there. Because, you know, in case I'm at the wrong place. Waited. Finally, the car came. He had a four-wheel drive. He sent his driver. So I told my girlie, okay, go back. So then I went and said, you know, nice. Lexus, full options, big-ass car. Ooh, it felt nice. So I sat down there. I think it was a Lexus 570 series or something. Okay, full black, everything black. So sitting there, feeling good. The driver was very courteous and I said, would you like this and that? I felt like a VIP. So it was all good. So having, you know, whatever I want to drink, I obviously like Red Bull. So I was drinking the Red Bull and I was trying to chit chat with this guy, but he didn't seem very chatty. He was just, yes sir, no sir, whatever. So fine. Finally, he left me at a place, their headquarters. And from the headquarters, we were waiting there. And finally, this guy came with his vehicle. Okay? It was a nice vehicle. What was it? Which brand was it? I even forgot. I think it was a 570 only. There was a Tahoe, there was a Lexus. Now, which one? I can't even remember. Okay. Anyway, there were 3 four-wheel drives. He was sitting in the biggest one. Can't remember. There was a Lexus. I think it was a Tahoe. Not very familiar with these brands of cars. So, big spacious, big ass spacious car, man. Vehicle. Went and sat down there and now it's so funny. Driver is here. He's sitting there. He's sitting in the front. Now, next seat is his secretary's. He has one secretary which reports him. And 2 other secretaries, and I'm behind. So I was sitting there, and you know, I was like, you know, a t-shirt and, but the, he was dressed up in a suit, full suit. Secretaries were dressed up prim and proper. And you're talking of nearly, I think, what, around 6 in the morning or something. And they all are decked up and you can literally smell the perfume, you know. They put this strong perfume in. And the AC is cool and all that and sat down. And I came, I said, morning and morning, everyone. And I sat down, I was just quiet. Wondering, are we going to chat or something? And as the driver started to move, these three vehicles, they were moving. This guy is like, he's just dictating notes. I'm just quiet, I'm listening, okay? Okay, this is inform that guy that this so-and-so and all that. And this is what the production will be. This is what the thing will be, blah, blah, blah. He goes on. And we are moving, huh? We are still moving. And then the secretary, sir, what about... So after that, you have the next appointment, so-and-so. Oh yeah, with that guy, tell him so-and-so, so-and-so, so-and-so. And these other two secretaries are busy writing. I was quiet. I was like, okay, this will go on for 15, 20 minutes and then maybe I'll start chit-chatting with him, you know, and try to rub shoulders, become a little close. That guy just didn't stop. He's still dictating notes. 6, went all the way to 6:30, 7, 7:30, bloody 8. I was like, what the fuck is this? He's not stopping, huh? They are going on with his timetable, with his schedule, with his this, with his that. And the secretary is busy writing. Finally, we stopped at a gas station. Stopped at a gas station. Thankfully, they stopped talking. I got up and I was like, okay, now it's my time to rub shoulders with the CEO after all. You know, I'm a networking guy. I want to rub shoulders because... So I was like, he was not bothered. He was just going. So I, you know, I kind of went and tried to. He was walking. I was like, I say, how are you doing? And, hey, fine. Everything was one word, one word. It was like as if he's recharging his batteries. Then he was like, just help yourself. Yeah. I was like, oh, that's quite a schedule. He's saying, yeah. Everything was like one word answer. Yeah, no, this, that. I was like, this guy doesn't seem to want to talk only. I was like, okay, fine. Then, again, sat in the car. And the whole way was the same bullshit. In between, I got bored. I was playing my game and all that. He just didn't stop. Then, after we landed there, we had the briefing, okay? And, you know, he was obviously staying at a very expensive hotel. We were going to stay in a smaller hotel. Okay, we are not going to stay in the VIP 5-star hotel like him. So after we got down there, first was a briefing for all of us. So he called his top guys and he called me also. Okay, and they were talking there. And this was how his schedule was. His schedule, okay, this is actual schedule. His schedule was 8 o'clock we reach, okay, or whatever. 8 o'clock we get up or we meet. Then 8:30 is the briefing. 9 o'clock, meeting 1, then 10 o'clock, meeting 2, then after that is 10:30 is tea break, and then, 10 o'clock after that is tea break, 10:30 is briefing again, then 11, meeting, 12, meeting, then 12:30 is, 12 o'clock is break, and then 12:30 is lunch, that goes up to 1:30, and 1:30 we get prepared for 2 o'clock. 2 o'clock is meeting till 3, 3 till 4, then 4 o'clock again, same thing. It's just at briefing and then tea break and all that, tea break and then briefing. Then 5, then 6, it goes all the way until the day is over, okay? Maybe at around 8 or something, day is over. Now, you might think 8 o'clock the day is over, they go home. No, the employees go home. This guy, along with his secretaries, you know, I told you, no, there were three secretaries. Where one secretary takes a break, the other one comes in. And this main one has two secretaries. And apart from them, each one of them has to answer. One has to answer emails, the other one has to do something else. And I was like, what the fuck is this? And this guy, at 8 o'clock, he would go get fresh, come back at 9, have a meeting again, and then 10 o'clock was networking. So I was like, okay, we're going to network. 10 till 12 or something, networking and dinner. And after 12, they meet at the bar where he buys alcohol and drinks for, you know, the people he wants to get buddy-buddy with. And this goes on all the way till 3 o'clock in the morning. I was like, what the fuck is that? And, you know, strict instruction, don't get drunk, don't this, don't that. After they finish, 3 o'clock, I didn't have the bloody stamina to stay all the way through. I told him, listen, if you don't need me, I'll go. At around, when I got fed up, I think at around 11, 11.30, I was tired, man. Fuck. I don't know what battery power this guy had. I went to sleep. We were supposed to meet 8 o'clock. You know, these guys were there sharp 8. I came a little bit late, and thankfully, because I was not the employee, they didn't ask me anything. But everyone was there on time. Even the CEO. I came a little late, and the lady was nudging me. Why are you late? I said, I just overslept. You know, I gave bullshit. So, and then I asked her, like, what time did you guys go and sleep? She said, till 3. And it seemed somebody had a meeting till 4 or something. Some shit like that. Second day, exactly the same shit. Okay, same shit. Day one, I was exhausted. Day two, I was like, what the fuck is this? And obviously, it was not like just meeting. There were other slots, like, you know, meeting at a conference, meeting at a venue, promoting this, promoting that, news TV, you know, holding the product, photographs, journalists, then paid sponsorship and all that. And day three, again, the same fuck. Oh my goodness. By day three, I was complete. I'll tell you this. Second day, my body itself was aching. Third day, I was like, fuck, I don't want to do this anymore, man. No wonder that guy paid me so much money. I was like, shit, I should have asked for more. And day three, again, same thing. I tried to keep my energy, drinking plenty of coffee. My head was like bloody heavy. And last day, thankfully, after 8, it was just networking. There was nothing important or all that. I just said, you know, if I'm not required, yeah, you can go. Because, you know, they were drinking with the big boys and, you know, girls were brought in for entertainment. And, you know, all the big guys enjoy with the hot girls and, you know, paid entertainment, basically. I was in no mood. Went to sleep. Next day, again, sharp on time, we have to meet. And then we have to drive back. As we are driving back, I seriously thought it was a 3-day event, and I thought, finished, now everyone will be relaxed. They're sitting in the bloody vehicle, and the guy is still dictating notes. Okay, put this as a press release, put this as the report, this is the meeting, this is the thing, this is that. Okay, my flight to Singapore, my flight to Malaysia, and then after connecting flight to Philippines, and this and that, and Thailand and India and this. I was just listening. I was like, you know, by the time my head was like, what the fuck? Like, what, this guy's a machine or what? So, thankfully, we stopped in between for lunch. Okay? We stopped for lunch. We got out. And he was sitting, you know, he normally sits with his secretary, whatever. So, this time I said, may I join you? So, he said, yeah, come. So, I sat down there and he was a little relaxed. Because obviously that event was over. So I said, can I ask you something? So he said, yeah, go ahead. Yeah, as he was eating, he said, yeah, go ahead. I said, you know, the event just got over. Don't you have a break? Like, aren't you taking a break? Like, you've literally been working like this. I said, don't get me wrong, but you just seem to be working. He laughed. Even the secretary, the main one, laughed. The other two were separate. He said, Loy, he's saying, you think this is first time? I said, yeah, for me, it's first time. I'm sure it's not first time for you. He's saying, I've been working like this from the age of 16. I said, yeah, 16. Like, I looked at him with a big question. He said, no, I was not a CEO that time, but I used to work hard as this. And that's how I reached where I am. And then, I don't know, he just opened up and started to talk to me. And even after food. He kept talking in the car. He didn't tell anything about the schedule. I don't know. He just must have felt happy he could open up. So he was talking to me about... coming after the Singh lunch, he asked the other secretaries to sit back and he made me sit where he could diagonally talk to me. So in a nutshell, he told me about his life. He stays in the same house, his wife and his kids. But when he gets up in the morning, they are sleeping. When he comes back, they are already retired for the day. So he says, there have been times where 3 to 4 months in the same house, I have not interacted with my children. I have not interacted with even my wife. In fact, I'll just say, hi, how are you? I don't even have time for sex. So I was like, what the fuck is that kind of life? And I was just thinking to myself. So I, you know, obviously, because you don't get to meet a CEO every time. So I asked him, is this a life of all CEOs? He said, no. Different CEOs have different schedules or lifestyle or whatever. He's saying, but this is my lifestyle. He's saying, but you can be rest assured, most of the CEOs do have a very, very, very tight schedule. He's saying, on a given day, we are talking of sometimes 10,000 emails, messages, correspondences. And that time, you know, social media was not that crazy. So he said, press releases, meetings, parties, whatever. And he's saying, you need to be ready for the next day. You do not have time to waste. And I said, aren't you afraid of your health? He's saying, yeah, I have a doctor who, if I'm sick, he'll come with me. I was like, huh? Okay. I asked him, like, you know, when do you stop? He's saying, the day I get tired or fed up. I said, you know, I asked him, like, where is going? Like, are you doing for the money? Money is relative. I do it because I love it. So I asked him a couple of more questions here and there. And, you know, by the time I reached home, it was not the exhaustion of those 3 days. I just reached home. I was like, what the fuck was this? I mean, I guess he loves what he does. But if this is how a CEO of a big company is, then I started wondering, okay, how does the CEO of, let's say, Microsoft or Tesla or the President of the United States, how do they live their lives? And what kind of life is that? And I'll tell you, on top of that, it is, you know, so fake. The, hey, hi, nice to meet you. And everyone's nice to meet you, so nice to meet you and all that. And even relations, they are so busy, they don't have even time for sex. That is why I understood why they pay money, get these hot girls, quick, go have sex quickly, bye-bye. Okay, then get back to work. And now it kind of made sense why their life is so mechanical. I understood why they bring hot girls, sometimes you just fuck and bye-bye. Because you're so busy, you don't have time for anything. So, it was then and there only I decided, I'm not going to be a CEO of a company. I don't want to be. Anyway, I was not going to be, given my face. I don't want to be. I'm never going to be. And this is not how I want to live my life, man. Yeah, I like to play a game. I like to watch a movie. I like to enjoy a little bit. I don't know if he does that. Maybe he has time for Candy Crush or watching few minutes while eating. But there also, when he's eating also, he's dictating notes. Anyway, I just thought I'd share this with you because what happens is, you know, most of us would never get a chance to meet a CEO. That was my first very intimate and very close interaction with a CEO. That was the first time that time. Ever since, I've met quite a number of them and I've realized like what goes into their life and the discipline and hard work. That is why when anyone puts CEO on their title, I begin to think like, what the fuck are you doing? That's why a real CEO will not have time to update his social media and all that bullshit and chat and show off with the big cars and big girls. They don't do that. They just, and you know, these gurus and coaches who say, I mentor other people for 7-figure income. That's so much fucking bullshit. Yeah. Where you see Satya Nadella chatting with people, or Elon Musk also, whenever he does, it's a strategic move. He is not stupid. Anyway, this was my experience. Since you guys wanted to know, And that is why I decided then and there only, no fucking way. No matter what the amount of money, this is not the life I want to live. I'm happy being symbol. I'm pretty sure there are many CEOs who don't live a life like this, who have a rather, I don't know if you can say balanced life, but I can tell you definitely their life is not easy. If a CEO of, you know, I wouldn't say it's a small or medium company, it's slightly large. If he's so busy, then you can imagine multinational giants and big companies and million-dollar firms and all that. I have no idea what they go through. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. This is me signing off. You guys take care.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.